An ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. This should be the mantra for a healthier and wealthier life. Having said that, today let us discuss a very important tool or a procedure that may stop a woman from going through one of the dreadful diseases like cervical cancer, the treatment of which is even more stressful. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, Womb to Super Womb. I am Dr. Samata with you on this journey towards a healthier you. I hope my last video on the most common complaint with which 8 out of 10 girls walk into a gynecology OPD, that is painful period and ways to make it pain-free, was helpful to each one of you. In episode 1, I mentioned to you all that cervical cancer is also preventable. And that is possible through a laboratory-based test called Pap smear, which I urge every woman to go for to maintain a healthier womb. Pap smear or Pap test is not a prevention to cervical cancer, but is a screening procedure by which abnormality in the cervix or cervical cells precisely can be identified, and pre-invasive carcinoma, that is a stage where there are a few cancerous cells but haven't spread entirely to the organ, is detected before they turn into cancerous condition. So basically, it is done to look for abnormality in the cervix or cervical cancer. There are many reasons why women end up having cervical cancer. One of the main reasons is negligence. Women usually tend to ignore their reproductive health. I'll give you an example. A woman who has had constant white discharge for a very long time in the sexually active phase of her life neglects, thinking it is quite common, or is caught up with her work and family life. And by the time she sees a gynecologist, it will be too late to reverse. Of course, there are various symptoms of cervical cancer and various types of vaginal discharges in terms of consistency, color, odor, and content of the discharge, which I will be talking about in the days to come. There are many risk factors for cervical cancer. Out of these risk factors, some factors are in your control and can be stopped, and a few causes you can't change but can be dealt with wisely so as to prevent the occurrence of cervical cancer in the long run. The most important being infective cause. This is probably one of the cancers where a particular type of virus named HPV or human papilloma virus is responsible, and since the cause is known, cervical cancer becomes a preventable one. HPV infection is transmitted through sexual activity. There are many types of human papilloma virus. Depending upon their potential to cause cancer, they are grouped into two. Out of them, two HPV types, 16 and 18, cause about 70% of precancerous and cancerous lesions in the cervix. You may go through the other risk factors here. Pap smear, when undergone according to the guidelines, is an effective cancer screening procedure. It can reduce the incidence of cervical cancer by approximately 80%. Generally, the reporting will be normal or abnormal pap smear. If the report is abnormal, it shows that there is a lesion. Could be either CIN, that is cervical intraepithelial neoplasia, or papilloma virus infection, or invasive carcinoma of the cervix. Whenever the report is doubtful or inconclusive, then the test should always be repeated. Please know that Pap smear helps to find changes in the cervical cells caused by human papilloma virus, but the virus cannot be detected through Pap test. How often you need a Pap smear depends on your age, that is routine recommendation, and secondly, your risk factors. In special situations or conditions, you may need the test more frequently. Women between the ages of 21 and 29 should get a Pap smear every 3 years. Women aged between 30 and 65 should go for Pap smear alone every 3 years and should go for Pap smear along with HPV test, what we call Pap and HPV co-test, every 5 years, or HPV test alone every 5 years. In pregnancy, Pap smear is one of the routine investigations in the first trimester. It's done early so that if there is any abnormality, the most appropriate treatment can be planned. Women above the age of 65 years may stop getting a Pap test if and only if she has had 3 negative Pap tests in the past 10 years and the last one performed within the past 5 years. A woman who has undergone total removal of uterus along with cervix may not need a Pap test. A woman who has undergone only removal of uterus, leaving behind the cervix, should go for Pap smear. The woman lies on the gynecological chair. The cervix is exposed with the speculum and inspected prior to bimanual examination or PV examination or pervaginal examination. Here, a lubricant or an anesthetic gel is not used as this can interfere with the results of the test. The material from the cervix is then collected using a spatula and a cytobrush from 2 different sites. One closer to vagina or ectocervix and another from inside the cervix or endocervix. The whole procedure takes about 10 to 20 minutes. The samples are collected, viewed under microscope in the laboratory, and results are given. Before you go for a Pap test as a part of routine screening, or when you are specifically suggested one by your gynecologist, please avoid use of any kind of vaginal medicines or douching, creams or jellies. Avoid sexual activity. Avoid spermicidal creams or foams at least 3 days before the day of your Pap test, as all these can give you inconclusive results. Also, avoid scheduling an appointment with your gynecologist for a Pap test during periods, especially when the flow is heavy, as it could reduce the visibility of the cervical opening and such a sample could give inaccurate results. No, a positive Pap smear does not confirm that a woman has cancer, but it indicates the need for further investigations. Whenever the test report is abnormal, the next test should be colposcopy and colposcopy-directed biopsy. If your doctor suggests a Pap test or colposcopy for your complaint or symptoms, please never ignore it. But know that, like any other laboratory tests, even Pap smear has its own limitations and is not perfect. Pap smear test is not painful, but there could be slight discomfort due to insertion of speculum. Most of the cervical cancers are caused by HPV, which is sexually transmitted. But not all cancers of the cervix stem from HPV, and hence, whether you are sexually active or not, you still need a Pap test. However, cervical cancer is rare in women who are sexually not active. Pap smear is an effective and easy screening tool against cervical cancer and is also cost effective when compared to the psychological stress and treatment costs that this cancer may bring. Cervical cancer is one of the most common cancers in the world and largely preventable. Many clinical studies have shown that increase in screening procedures like pap smear is inversely proportional to the number of cervical cancer cases. Let each one of us create this awareness, encourage women to undergo a pap test, and make every womb a super womb. So if you found this video informative, then please hit the like button, comment, share with all your dear ones, and do not forget to subscribe if you haven't. In my next video, I will be talking about menopause. Stay healthy and stay tuned. Thank you.